What's up, guys? My name is Itamari, and in today's tutorial, we're gonna be covering LCD I2C and ESP32. So we're gonna be learning how to interface an LCD display with this microcontroller, which is ESP32. And the sketch that I'll be showing in this video is very simple. Okay, on the LCD I2C, we just have 4 pins. So the with the SCL pin and SDA pin, the VCC pin, and the ground pin. The potentiometer is to adjust the light, the backlight, and this connector. If we take out this connector, we're gonna turn off the backlight. If we take out this connector, so now if we want interface this LCD with our microcontroller, which is ESP32, we need to connect the pin SCL to pin D22 of the microcontroller, and the SDA pin, the data pin, goes to is going to be attached to pin 21. Okay, pin 21 is over here. So this pin is going to be connected to pin SDA. The VCC pin of the our LCD display, it goes to pin to VIN pin. So the pin VIN can be working as an input pin and as an output pin. Now the ground of the LCD display, of course, goes to ground of the our microcontroller. So we've just wired up the LCD display. To upload the program to our microcontroller ESP ESP32, we're gonna be using a Samsung cable so that we can upload the sketch. That's a Samsung cable, a mobile cable charger. Okay, so it's working. Okay guys, as you can see, the backlight of the our LCD display is on, so is the ESP32. So now we need to move to our code. This is our code. So we need to install this library, and here we create two variables, the LCD columns, which is going to save this value on an LCD display with 16 columns and two rows. So here in this line, we are creating an object called LCD, which has three parameters. The first one is the address of the LCD display. The second is the columns, and the third parameter is the rows. Now in void setup, we initialize the LCD I2C and return on the LCD backlight, and so we're gonna print out this message on the LCD display. And to print out this message, we need to set the cursor position. Okay, here's we set the cursor to first column, first row. So in today's video, we are now using or put some codes inside of void loop. So that's void. So now if I want to upload the sketch to our ESP32 microcontroller, we need to choose the right board. For me, it is ESP32 dev module, and the port that my laptop has detected is COM5. Okay, now I'm ready to upload the sketch. So while we upload the sketch, we need to press the boot button, but this is not the moment. We have to wait some. Yeah, now we can press the boot button. Okay, it's done. Now the code was uploaded. Now we press the enable button like that. Okay, so we can see the message hello world. Okay guys, so thank you so much, and I see you in the next video. Thank you.